This particular part of the forest is very rich in bird life. One can see many species because there is plenty of water in that small river and plenty of food in all forms. As you know, different birds eat different foods. Some are insect eaters, while others eat seed only. One can usually tell by the shape of the beak what kind of food they live on. Let us just listen for a while. That is a trumpeter hornbill, that black and white bird with the rather pronounced and different beak. There is the yellow-billed hornbill, quite a common variety, with a very large yellow bill. Look above the treetops. Here come some grey hornbills. Such a plaintive cry in flight, also with a large horn-shaped beak. This tells me that these hornbills have a large variety of feeding habits. Fruit, insects, small lizards, and seeds. The hornbills are also beautiful in flight as they glide above and between the trees. There goes a red-billed hornbill. Listen to that. It is the sound of two ground hornbills. A spooky sound indeed. But look, they are on the ground. What large birds they are. And how colorful, with red neck and black plumage. They eat frogs, mice, and lizards, and do not glide among the trees like their smaller cousins. Of course, in Africa, there are many other types of hornbills. To the east, the crested hornbill and the crowned hornbill. To the west, Monteiro's hornbill. And across the center of Africa, Bradfield's hornbill. Now all of these hornbills, except the ground hornbill, have a strange nesting habit. They make their nests in hollow trees, and after the female has laid her eggs, the male plasters up the entrance with mud, and he leaves only a small opening through which he feeds her while she sits on the eggs. Now the ground hornbills do not do that. They nest between large stones or in large hollow trees. And when the female leaves the nest, the male takes over and sits on the eggs. There is a tale from Central Africa which explains why the other hornbills plaster their wives into their nests. There was once a pair of very happy hornbills, Mr. and Mrs. Umkolwane, who made a lovely nest in a tree, just like other birds, open at the top and rounded at the bottom, and lined with feathers and soft grasses. Mr. Umkolwane would fly far away to find tasty morsels to feed his dear wife, who was sitting patiently on the eggs. Every day, he would have to fly further and further away to find food, and was often gone for long periods of time. Mrs. Umkolwane would watch as other hornbills flew by, gliding above and between the trees with grace and freedom. She was very bored, One day, while her mate was very far away, another beautiful male came flying by. He said, "Why are you sitting there all alone? Your husband has probably flown off and left you forever. Come and fly over the treetops with me and enjoy your life, rather than sit on that dismal nest." Mrs. Umkolwane fell under his spell, and away they flew. Mr. Umkolwane returned to find his wife was gone and the eggs cold. He sat on the eggs and waited, but alas, his wife just did not return. After many weeks, he hatched out and cared for four beautiful chicks. He did all the work, caring for them until they left the nest. Now two wise old ground hornbills saw all this treachery and warned all the other male hornbills that in future they should nest in hollow trees and seal their wives in with mud until the chicks are hatched, and feed their wives through a small slit. Of course, the ground hornbill does not do a lot of flying and is never tempted to go flirting and gliding among the trees with other birds. If his mate leaves the nest, he does not have to look very far for her, although they have a habit of calling to each other all the time, just in case.